In this program, we'll find whether the given byte is positive or negative. And the logic used here is, we are checking, say for example, we are taking an example of number 73. And in binary, we can represent this as 0111 and 0011. Now we are checking the MSB bit. If it is 0, it is a positive number. And if it is 1, it is negative number, right? So example for a negative number is 80. So we get to 1000 and 0000. So if this is this one, I mean MSB is 1, we are getting the byte as negative. So I've taken the number here 50H. 50H can be represented as 0 0 1 0 1 and 0 0 0. Since the MSB bit is 0, I should get on the console the display as the given number byte is positive. So I'll display two strings. Message 1, I declare it as given byte is positive. Message 2, I declare it as given byte is negative. Okay, and these two are for setting up the data segment. Now what you do is you need to test the MSB bit. So you take the number into AL, right? So AL comma DAT, that is 50H will move into AL. Now shift left AL by 01. So what happens here is, if you shift left, your data, that is 0101 and triple four zeros, this is 50. So your, if you shift this left, arithmetic shift, the 0 will come and sit into the carry's place. Okay, and here to the LSB, the zeros will be added. Okay, so if you look into the instruction set of 8086, you will come to know the working of shift left or shift arithmetic left. So you will get the MSB bit shifted to carry flag, and the LSB will be loaded with zeros. Now I am checking whether my carry flag is set. Set means what? 1. If it is 1, then we already know that the number is negative, and if it is 0, then the number is positive. So the logic used is pretty simple. You shift left and check whether the carry is 1 or 0. If there is no carry, no carry means 0, so number has to be positive. So it will go to the label positive, and it, the string which has to be printed is given byte is positive, that is message 1. So load into DX message 1, move AH comma 09H. This is the procedure to display a string. Move AH comma 09H in 21H dot exit and end. And if there is 1, right, if there is 1 in the carry flag, then load the second message, that is LEA DX comma message 2, and jump last. Why jump last? Otherwise you will be printing the message 1 again. So that is why if you want to print negative message, jump last. Last is this label. Since DX is pointing to message 2, it will print the second string, that is given byte is negative. So only one shift towards the left determines whether the number is positive or negative. Now in this program, we are checking whether the given byte is even or odd. See, as we have done in the previous program, we have checked whether the given byte is positive or negative. That is solely depending on the MSB bit status. If MSB bit is 1, it is negative, and if MSB bit is 0, it is positive. Here we are checking whether the given byte is even or odd. Okay, now how do we check it? Say take a number, even number, say 60 or 64H. Now how do we represent it in binary? 0101106 and 4 is 0100. And take a odd number 63. How do we represent it? 0110 and 3 is 0011. Now, what is the difference? How do we say that this is negative and this is positive? It is depending upon the LSB bit, right? LSB bit. If LSB bit is 0, it is even, and if LSB bit is odd, if LSB bit is 1, it is odd. So that is a simple logic used to check whether the given byte is even or odd. So what do you do here? You define two strings. You define the data which is 53, and obviously 53 is an odd number, and you should get on the console. The console should display this string, that is given byte is odd. Okay, this dollar sign indicates the end of the string. Okay, now as usual, as per the previous program, we are doing this as same as the previous program. We had shifted the data left and we checked for the carry. Here we are shifting the data right and we are checking for the carry. So in order to shift the data left or right, we need to take the data into AL, because we have simple shift operation that has to be done on the data which is present in AL register only. So move AL comma data, so AL will get 53. SHR AL comma 01H, that means shifting right. Now jump on no carry. If there is no carry, if we shift this data right, see shift left, you saw that it will go into carry flag. Even shift right, the bit which you are going to shift will be in carry flag. So if there is no carry means zero. So if there is no carry, it has to be an even number. So go to the even label and load DX with message 1, which indicates that the given byte is even. And then move AH, 09H in 21H. This is a common procedure to display a string which we already know. If you do not know, please look into my previous videos. Okay, now if there is a carry means one shift is enough to check whether the number is even or odd. So if there is a carry, it is an odd number, so load the DX with address of message 2, that is this string. Then go to jump directly to last, so that you will not print the first string. You need to print the second string because it is odd. So move h comma 09 in 21h and exit. So since the number is 53 and it is fixed, and we already know that it is odd, 53 means 53 is 0 1 0 1 and 3 is 0 0 1 1. So if we shift, the LSB bit will go and set in carry flag. So carry flag will be having 1. Now jump on carry, jump on no carry, that is not valid. So it will come down and it will load the message 2, that is given by it is odd, and it will jump to last and display. So the second string is displayed, that is given byte is odd in this case. If you take a different byte, you'll get the different string being displayed on the console. Now in this program, we are transferring a string from one memory location to another. So we are declaring our string as electronics, right? And we are declaring the destination wherein the string has to be transferred, as well as the count. This count indicates the number of characters in the string. Okay. Now, as you can see here, electronics has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 characters, right? So the count will be, count is given to be DSTR minus STR1. Now what is the meaning of that? Even in DSTR, we have defined DSTR minus STR1. See, STR1 is a memory location from which your electronics is defined. Electronic string is defined. So if E is defined, say for example electronics, I'll take here electronics, if E is present, E means its ASCII value will be stored. So if this is present at some address 1000, right, so this will be at 1001, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, right. So 10 means it is 1008.
right? So if the first character is E of electronics, that is present at the address 1000, if we assume that it is at 1000, then the last character has to be present at 1000A, because 1000, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, right? So 1000A is the address at which S is present. Now, that is 1000A. Now, if what is the memory location after that? It is 1000 and B, right? So that is, see, this is the starting point of STR1, and this is the next point, DSTR, because after STR1, DSTR is defined. Now, DSTR is 1000 and B, and what is STR1? 1000. So what is the length you get is 11, B. B is 11. So that is why, in order to get the length, we are defining this subtraction. DSTR minus STR1 means it is 11. So 11 memory locations you are duplicating with zeros. That is the meaning of that. Because you are duplicating zeros because you want to store this string in that memory location. And the count is again DSTR minus STR1. It is, as I've told you here, 1000B minus 1000 is B. Okay, here we are transferring the data from data segment to extra segment. Okay, because the string instructions usually are from transferring the string, I mean character, from data segment to extra segment. So here these two are defining data segment. Now we are making data segment and extra segment same. Okay. Because your string instructions work from data segment to extra segment, that is why. And one more catch here is, in data segment the string pointer is SI, okay, and in extra segment the string pointer is DI. That is, in data segment string pointer is source index, and in extra segment the string pointer is destination index. This is the point to be noted. Okay, so that is why, in order to achieve that, we are defining the data segment and we are defining the extra segment at the same. That means we are, after data segment, we are defining it to be extra segment. Okay. So LEA SI, STR1. So what does it do? SI will point to the first element, that is E. And then you point DI to the destination, because destination index will be in extra segment, and we have made extra segment and data segment same. Okay. So the data is transferred from DS, that is data segment, to extra segment, and in data segment the pointer is SI, memory pointer, and in extra segment the memory pointer is DI. So that is why SI will point here and DI will point to the blank spaces, 11 blank spaces, because DSTR minus STR1 is 11. Now move CX, count. Why? How many characters has to be sent, that we should know, right? So count will have 11, so that you move into CX. Now this CLD is clear direction flag. Okay, this is clear direction flag. Now if, depending upon the direction flag, the string will be transferred. Now if you clear the direction flag, and the direction flag will come in the 8086 flag register structure. So if you clear the direction flag, the string will be in auto increment mode. I mean, string transfer takes place in auto increment mode. Now what is auto increment mode? Your SI and DI will be auto incremented if you use CLD, that is clear direction flag. If you use STD, your source index, that is SI and DI, will be in auto decrement mode. Okay, that has to be clear. If you give CLD, it will be auto increment mode. If you give STD, it will be in auto decrement mode. Now this is an instruction which is used to transfer data from data segment to extra segment, wherein in data segment the pointer is SI and in extra segment the pointer is DI. Okay, so this repeat move SB is an instruction which
this will transfer the data. See, move SB is the, what is the definition of move SB? Is this data in data segment pointed by SI will be sent to extra segment pointed by DI, and this repeat will work until CX becomes 0. Okay, so what happens is move SB, okay, move SB is data pointed by SI in data segment, that is E, will be moved to DI, I mean data pointed by DI in extra segment. So E will come and sit here because you have 11 zeros that is duplicated here. Next, what happens is this, because of this repeat, CX will be decremented. Okay, CX was 11, now decremented, it will become 10, it is not 0. So again the transmission takes place, and I have also told that the direction flag is cleared. So SI and DI will be auto incremented. Now what happens, SI was pointing here, auto increment means what? It will point to the next. Even DI will point to the next memory location of containing zeros, because we have cleared 11 zeros there. I mean 11 memory locations with zeros. So then again the transfer of L takes place. Again because of repeat, CX will be decremented. It will check whether it is 0. From 10 it will be 9. So it is not equal to 0. Again move SB will take place. Since the direction flag is cleared, auto increment of SI and DA will take place. So finally electronics full string will be copied here. That means we are able to transmit the string from one memory location to another. So after that, whatever is being transmitted here, I need to print, because we have to check whether the same string is transmitted here. So what do we do? How do we print the string? How do we print the string which is present here? Load this into DX. Move AH, 09H and in 21H. This is how a string will be moved from one memory location to another. Now in this program, we are taking a string and we are reversing it and displaying the reverse string. So the basic idea is pretty simple. You are taking a string, say the string which I have chosen here, say I have declared the string as string 1. You need not always specify it as string 1, it can be any other label. And I define a byte because it is a character byte. Okay, every character will have its own ASCII code, so it is ASCII code is having a byte. So STR1 is a memory location at which string Malayalam is defined. Now as seen in the previous case, we need to allocate some memory locations so as to have the reversed string. So and that is got by address of RST minus address of STR1, and this concept I have explained in my previous video, so you can have a look into it. If this is 1000 and if STR1 starts with 1000 address, that is at 1000 M is defined. This is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, so another M is defined at 1008. So the next address is 1009. So RST is at address 1009 and STR is at address 1000. So what is the difference here? It is 9. So 9 blank memory spaces will be allocated and each will be copied with 00. Now again, count is the number of counts, number of character count in the declared string. Now the logic here is, if you have defined here, this is the given string, I need to reverse this. That means the character which is at the least position should come at the top, I mean should come in the most significant position. So then this A, then L, then A, then Y, A, L, A, M again. This M, the most prominent M, will come to the least prominent position. So this is the reverse string. So this is the logic used. So what I need to do is, whenever I have told this, whenever you are doing string operation, the transfer takes place from data segment pointed by SI to extra segment pointed by DI. Okay, I've explained this in my previous videos as well. So I need to point SI to the last position, right? So that this M will come here. Right? Since Malayalam is a palindrome means even if I reverse it and compare the original string and the reverse string, they are equal. If you take any other string, say David, and if you reverse this, it will be D-I-V-A-D. These two are not equal. This is not a palindrome. Now, what do I do here is, the logic is pretty simple. I make SI to point to the last position, and from data segment, I move this to the extra segment. Now, for that to happen, I need to initialize my data segment and initialize the extra segment as well, because I am moving the string from data segment to the next extra segment. So as usual in data segment, you need to have SI as a pointer. I have mentioned here, so LEA SI comma STR1. So SI is pointing at this point, this character. Now LEA DI comma RST. So RST is what? The destination. So DI will be pointing there. So if I were to write, say, Malayalam here, this is SI pointing here, okay, and DI is having blank spaces filled with zero, right? All are zeros because we have subtracted the next address with the previous address, RST minus STR1, so you'll get 9, and we have duplicated with zeros. So SI is pointing here, and this is data segment, this is extra segment, and always you know that in extra segment the pointer is DI. So that is why LEA DI comma RST. Now count, you move to CX. Now as I've told, I want to make SI to point to the last. So what do you do? Add SI with CX. Say for example CX is 9 because Malayalam character size is 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 8, 9. So if I add SI with CX, I will be getting, I need to add 9 to SI. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That means it is pointing to the next position to that of last M. So it is pointing here, right? But what I want is, I want SI to point here. Everyone is clear? I guess. So, because I need to copy this into this location. So, that is why they I have written here decrement SI. So that SI points to the last character. So, SI points to this point. Now, a common loop which has to happen. I mean, the copying loop. So, now SI is pointing to the last position. Now what you do is STD. See, there are two conditions on direction flag, STD and CLD. I have told CLD is auto increment mode of DI and SI, whereas STD is decrement mode. Okay, auto decrement mode of SI and DI. Now what happens here is, see, STD stands for auto decrement because I need to decrement SI, right? Whereas for CLD, it is increment. So let me see what is the logic used. Let us see. STD load SB. Now what is this load SB doing? Always remember, load SB working is, the load SB will transfer the data in data segment pointed by SI to AL register. Okay, so what is the data in data segment pointed by SI? SI is pointing to this end, so that will be moved to AL. So that is the work of load SB. Okay, next, your clearing direction flag. So it will be auto increment mode. Now storage B is, it will store the content of AL into memory location pointed by DI. Memory location in extra segment pointed by DI. See, these are the two operations happening. The data pointed by SI in data segment will be moved to AL with the help of load SB, and with the help of store SB, STOSB, the value of AL will be copied to memory pointed by DI in extra segment. So it will be stored in this position, extra segment. This M will come and sit here. Okay. Now what happens after this? The loop L1 will be executed. Loop L1, we already know, it decrements the value of CX and checks whether it is equal to 0. What is the value of CX here? CX is the number of characters. So it is 9. It will decrement and it will become 8. It is not equal to 0. So it will come back again here. Right? So what is STD doing now? STD is set direction flag. So it will auto decrement. Auto decrement means what? It will, the SI will point to A, I mean the previous memory location. So this will be loaded into AL because of load SP. Then again the direction flag is cleared. So the auto increment mode is the procedure of transferring the string will be auto increment. So store SB will do the content of AL into ESC to DI. What is AL? What is the content of AL? DCA. That will be moved to ESC to DI. See, store SB is given, CLD is given that so that DI will increment itself. It is auto increment. So this A will be stored here. This A will come and sit here. So similarly, this transfer will happen 9 number of times because of the content of CX. Loop L1 will loop itself for 9 times because of the content of CX in it. So in ESC, in the extra segment pointed by DI, that is at RST, our reverse string will be stored, right? So that is displayed here, LEA DX, RST, because if you want to show display a string, you need to put it into DX and then display it, right? And move AH,09H in 21H. This is the procedure to display the string. So first is store SB, make SI to point to the last character, store SB, load SB, right? And then set direction flag, load SB, and clear direction flag and store SB. These are the four instructions which will transfer the data from the last to in order to form a new string, which is the reverse string of the original string which is mentioned, taken as a input. Now you have the original string, right, and you have the reverse string. If you compare it, compare them both, and if you say that they are equal, if you find that they are equal, then the given string is a palindrome. So the next extension of this program would be a program for finding whether a given string is palindrome or not. Now in this program we are trying to find, search for a character in a string, right? So you have to declare a string, which is electronics, which I have declared in this case, and I am accepting a character that has to be searched from the keyboard. Okay, so as we have done in the previous case, string 1 is electronics, count is obviously count minus str1, because count is having some memory address, str1 is also having memory address, so subtraction of that will give you the count, and these two messages are for sending the message into the console stating that the character is found or character is not found. This is initialization of data segment, and even extra segment is initialized just after data segment. Now the logic here is you are taking the character from the keyboard, right, and comparing it with individual characters. So scan B, CASCASB is the instruction that is used to search the character in a string. Okay, it will compare the content of AL with comparison. This is comparison. Content of AL with data pointed by DI in extra segment. Okay, so this is the working of scan SP. So the data in AL will be compared with data pointed by DI that in extra segment. So what do? You make DI to point to the string which we have declared. Okay, then move CX comma count, that is CX will get whatever count in the electronics, it is 11. 11 is the count that will be moved to CX. Now CLD, we already know it is auto decrement mode of SI or DI. Okay, so and now this two lines, move AH comma 01H and IN 21H, it is used to take the data from the keyboard. Okay, this is an DOS command that is used to take the data from the keyboard. Say for example, if I want to search T in this string, so the program execution will stop until you give an input from the keyboard. So move AH comma 01H and IN 21H is an interrupt that will wait until you supply some input from the keyboard. So say for example you have given character T, its ASCII code will be stored in AL register. Okay, so what happens is when the program is being executed, it will come and stop here because you have given an interrupt, and this interrupt will be facilitated first, and this will be executed only when you give input from the keyboard. So say for example you have pressed key T, that T, that means its ASCII value will be present in register AL. Okay, now this is repeat if not equal scan SB. What is this doing is you need to repeat the comparison until your CX value will become 0. The CX value becomes 0. CX value is what? It is 11. It is number of characters in the given string. So until that becomes 0, the scanning is done. See, what you have taken here is T. Taken from the keyboard is T. So that will be in AL. Right? I have explained. Now, that will be compared with character which is pointed by DI. Present in ES, that is E. Okay, because DI is pointing to the string. So what happens in the first go? AL is T, T will be compared with E. It is not equal. So CX will be reduced and repeated. So next is L, again not equal. It will get repeated. CX will come down. Then again E, it is not equal. C, not equal. CX will be decremented. So T, when you encounter T in the string pointed by DI in extra segment, that zero flag will be set. Okay, when that zero flag is set, you just go to L1. What is L1 doing? When the character is found, I need to display the string the character is found. So L1, in L1, LEADX comma message 1. Right. Move AH comma 09H in 21H. This is the routine to display the string. Now after the scan gets over, that means when it will get over, when the CX value becomes 0, that means after 11 comparisons, Say for example, if not T, I had given X as an input from the keyboard. It will search repeat if not equal scan as B. It will search 11 times and it is not equal to 0. I mean, there is no matching. Jump if 0 is not happening. So what it does is it comes to the next instruction, LEA DX, message 2, saying that the character is not found. So then it will jump to L2 because I don't want to display message 1. I want display message 2. So it will come here and display this. So this is how a scanning of a character which is taken from the keyboard takes place. So you have a string which you have already declared. You take the input from the keyboard, you compare them and display the appropriate message onto the console.